Whitewater, Colorado, just south of Grand Junction, is full of parched ridges and high peaks. At 4,780 feet, it's sunny for about 70% of the year, making it really dry. So dry, you start to feel your lips chap after just a few hours outside. Hidden up in the mountains, Colorado Mesa University's Forensic Investigation Research Station, or FIRS for short. Researchers here leave bodies to decompose in the open, arid environment. And what they learn about the process has improved forensic science and could help solve crimes.
We're kind of out in a fairly isolated area. Is that intentional?
I think it helps. It absolutely helps to keep it a little bit more private. I think also if you put someplace like this in the middle of a suburban neighborhood, people might not be happy about that. We are in a semi-arid climate, so we're very low in moisture. We get a total of maybe 8 inches of precipitation a year.
That's like nothing.
Temperature, the heat certainly helped dry things out. Mm-hmm. The altitude makes a difference, both in terms of the humidity or lack thereof. It does get drier as you go up, but we also increase in solar radiation. We're closer to the sun. And again, as solar radiation impacts the skin of living people, it also impacts and changes the skin of dead people.
FIRS is one of a handful of forensic science investigation stations across the U.S. At these sites, researchers train students, work with law enforcement, coroners, and forensic scientists, and they even conduct their own research. FIRS is the westernmost station, though, and the environment here affects bodies differently than in the humid plains of Texas or a temperate valley in Tennessee. Behind this 10-foot fence and razor wire, remains stay identifiable for much longer.
We see like mummification as opposed to skeletonization, so the tissue desiccates and remains there for a long time after death, years after death, as opposed to in other places where it's just decomposes down to bone.
This has helped science improve the reliability of measurements of decomposing remains. Investigators can get a more accurate picture of a crime scene, for example, if they know how and when a body started to break down.
We look at the different species of blowflies and maggots that we have here and how they develop so that we can apply that information to the climate that they're found in and use that to say, oh, it's likely this person would have died in a cool weather time of year, or, oh, it looks like they've been dead for about this long. The work that we do directly applies to things that happen out in the world. So if somebody finds a body, you don't necessarily know what happened or when it happened, but we can, because we're studying these processes, we can use the information that we find to give people closure and information and figure out the story behind what happened and just kind of complete the picture and provide more understanding.
To help grow that understanding, FIRS recently expanded, adding 40 acres in Park County, Colorado. At 9,600 feet above sea level, that site is twice the elevation of the Whitewater site, and its subalpine climate will offer even more unique insights into decomposition.
They're going to have feet and feet of snow in winter. We'll see what that kind of cold and snow does to remains.